Cinema 5D at IBC 2019 is brought to you by B&H, the professional source for all your video needs. CVP, the leading specialist in creative cine, video, and photo solutions. Fomex, devoted to remarkable light. Manfrotto, imagine more. And FUJINON, ultimate optical performance.
Hi, I'm Adam from Cinema 5D, and you're joining us here on the Adobe booth at IBC 2019, and I'm talking to Carl from Adobe. Hi, Carl.
Hi, happy to be here.
A new tool that you've kind of like hinted at for Adobe Premiere is the Auto Reframe tool, something that got me particularly really excited. Can you tell us about Auto Reframe and why you designed it? What was the need?
Well, the need that we've seen is more and more we need to deliver content to more and more screens. And in particular, as we move into mobile devices, we're starting to see more and more of a need to take the widescreen content that we've come to love on our televisions and reframe it for phones, vertical video, square video. So just as we got everything all nice and widescreen, we moved away from 4x3 television. Now, all of a sudden, this has come back. Trying to keep the video interesting and keep the main focus that's in the video in frame is a very manual and tedious process. So we thought, well, if we take our Adobe Sensei technology, our machine learning, our AI technology, and throw it at this problem, we can actually have the computer deduce what the most interesting bit in the frame is. And with auto reframe, it will go through and actually create the keyframes for you so that it becomes a very quick and easy process without a lot of manual labor.
I think it's going to be a really, really powerful tool. When do you expect to implement it into the next update of Premiere Pro CC?
This is one of those cases where, obviously, if you've seen around the booth, we are showing it. It's close. I can't give you an exact time frame yet. The best answer I can give you is we'll ship it when it's ready. But we're definitely super excited about it. I'm loving how they've implemented it in the software because you can use it on a clip-by-clip basis if necessary, but there's also a big ability to use it across an entire sequence. And when you do that, it will even do some really nice, there's some nice detail in the way that they've taken this AI engine and applied it to the problem.
So yeah, just reflecting on that, one thing that I was quite impressed with, as you mentioned, is the non-destructive element of it.
Yes.
You can apply it to clips, you can apply it to already edited and reframed and clips that have been keyframed as well. So I think it's going to be a really, really powerful tool, not just for video producers, but also for broadcasters and anyone that's actually repurposing archive footage as well. Carl, thank you so much for your time here at the Adobe booth. And I guess we'll just kind of watch this space for when it happens, when
Absolutely.
It comes. Brilliant.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Guys, thank you so much for watching the video here at IBC 2019. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel and check out the rest of the coverage from the show. Thanks for watching.